Hello children, how are you? Today we are going to have a drawing class. I'm Gracia ma'am and I'm going to teach you how to draw a boat. Do you all like to draw a boat? Today we are going to draw a different houseboat. Shall we start drawing?
Keep your drawing copies in the landscape position. Make two dots like how I'm showing. Draw a curved line to join the dots. The line is not straight, but it is curved a little bit. Now from the first dot, you draw another curved line, which will be the sides of the boat. Now we draw the water. We use curved lines to draw the water. Draw one more line so that we can make the boat colorful. That is the pole that we are drawing. Use a scale to draw a very straight line. Now we are going to draw a house. I feel this house is a little big. Now let's erase that and make it a little small so that we'll have space for the sail. You all know how to draw a house. Two standing lines, one sleeping line. You may use your scale. Now make a dot in the middle and now join the sides like alphabet A. You can use your scale also. Try to draw freehand. If you're not getting it straight, you can use your ruler. What is missing? Door and two windows. That's it. A house is ready. Now we have to draw the sail. See, from that point, draw a curved line to the pole. Make two dots and join the line. And from the other side to the tip of the boat. Now at the top, make two dots. We are going to join these two dots. Observe carefully, the lines are curved. Next, we join the next two dots. Again, we join the next two dots. In case you're not getting the flow, you can change your hand position and then do it easily. Now I want to draw one more layer of waves. What is missing? What can you add more? Clouds. That's a big cloud. That's a medium-sized cloud. That's a very small cloud. What else is missing? Sun. Very good. The sun is smiling at you. What are we going to draw next? Wow, birds. I'm going to stop drawing here. I want you to make the picture more creative. What else can be there in this picture? I want you to draw some human beings, a picture on the sail, and then you will start the outlining. As I'm doing, take a black sketch pen and start with the outline. Outline the picture completely over the pencil mark slowly. Use a scale if required, or wherever required. Very good. I think you are doing it neatly, and you're going to surprise me with a colorful boat. Did you draw a few people sailing on the boat? Did you draw fish in the water? We are almost complete with this step. The next step is coloring. Before that, we have to erase all the pencil lines that we see. Quickly erase it off, clean the page, get ready with your color pencils to color. So we know the sun is yellow. I'm going to color the clouds gray. So before we color, I tell you the coloring rules. Color in the borders first, and then you fill inside. You may ask me why. If you do like this, your color will not go out and your pictures will look very neat. Did you notice my circular movement near the edges? Because that is a curved surface, I'm using round movements, circle movements to fill in the edges. So I have explained rule number one, color from the border to inside. What is rule number two? Color in circular motion in curved surfaces. Now the next rule is to color in the same direction. Color in the same direction. And rule number four, don't leave any white space. You have to color every corner. See, I took red for the roof and I'm coloring the borders. Then I will fill inside in the same direction without any gap. Spend some time and make it neat. Pick your desired color. Don't follow the colors I'm using. You can take any colors as you wish. Coloring the door brown, and after this you will color the people that you draw on the boat. I'm going to color the boat in two colors, purple and brown. First in the borders, always don't forget. Then fill inside. Now we are going, I'm going to teach you a little bit of color mixing. I took orange, I colored the pole orange, and now I took brown, and over the orange I'm coloring in brown. Same thing for the boat. I'm going to color the boat in orange first, across the borders, very carefully, and near the water area even more carefully. Now I fill inside in the same direction without any gap. Now I take dark brown and I'm going to color over the orange place. Notice the color change. You can try this with other colors too. Avoid using black. We are getting wooden effect. I will not be coloring the sail. I want you to draw a logo on the sail. Logo means any symbol of a sun or a pirate symbol, and color it. That is your creative corner. Now I move on to the sky. We know the sky is blue and water is also blue. I chose light blue for the sky and I will be coloring the water in dark blue so that we can differentiate between water and sky. Color the borders first and then inside. Do it in the same direction. In places like the sky and water, I have seen children color in different directions. Maintain the same direction and see to it that you fill in all the white spaces. I know you're all exhausted. There's little more to go. Did you like your picture? Now take dark blue and color very carefully. You should not mix it with the sky. Before you color the water, remember to color the fish that you drew. Follow the same colors for the sky and water. You may change the colors for the boat. We have completed the picture.
I hope you all enjoyed today's class. Did you all do a neat work? Did you draw neatly and color neatly? I want you to follow the same rules in all the drawings that we do henceforth. Till then,